Computer won't boot past BIOS. Here are 5 ways you can fix it. Before we move forward, do us a favor by subscribing to our channel and liking this video. It's free and helps us a lot. We do tons of research to find the working solutions for you. Your little support will help us continue making solution videos for you and others. Now, let's get started. Method 1. If your computer refuses to boot up, it doesn't always mean that you have some internal issues or software configuration problem. It can also happen due to some damaged hardware like RAM or hard disk. These components are very crucial to run the system. Any mishap to these hardware components can result in your computer stuck on BIOS screen. In most of the cases, the hard disk is the culprit behind this problem. You should check for any damage to your hard drive. Go to the BIOS setting and check if the boot menu shows the hard disk on the list. If it does, make sure it is set at the top. You also need to check that the RAM and the hard drive are connected properly to the motherboard and the power supply is uninterrupted. Because when a computer starts up, these things are the primary components required for booting. If your PC warns with a beep sound while entering the BIOS, it indicates that your RAM or other hardware is not properly working. You can try changing the memory slot of RAM. Method 2. Sometimes external hard drive or flash drive can cause an issue with boot up. If you have connected any external storage space with your computer, your PC might start booting from the external drive. You should disconnect all external storage connected to your PC, such as external hard drive or flash drive. Then boot your PC and check if the problem continues. Method 3. The next thing you can do is change the BIOS settings to default and see if that solves the issue. On the BIOS screen, go to the Load Setup Defaults option. Now, your BIOS settings are changed to default values. Save and exit the BIOS. Method 4. Another thing you can do is change the CMOS battery. Open the CPU cabinet and detach the CMOS battery. Replace it with a new one and then see if that solves the issue. Method 5. The next thing you can do is update your BIOS. The steps to update BIOS differ for every motherboard. Check the motherboard's manufacturer's website on how to update the BIOS of your motherboard and then do it. Once the BIOS is updated, check if the issue persists. So that's it. Subscribe to our channel and get quick solutions to all your tech issues. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching and always remember that we are here to help you out.